In Construct 2, the timer behavior can be used to trigger an event after a period of time. The timer behavior can trigger the event once or repeatedly over time. Let's take a look at how to use the timer behavior in a Construct 2 project. To start off with, I have these four grass tiles set up. If we go into the sprite editor, you can see I have another animation called Dirt. What I want to do is display the tiles with grass when the layout begins, but if the player clicks on a tile, I want the grass to be cut and the animation switched to the dirt tile. Then, we'll use the timer behavior to trigger the grass to automatically regrow after a period of time. The first thing we need to do is go into the event sheet and set it up so that the ground object switches to the dirt animation when the player clicks it. Let's add an event, using the mouse object. And we want to use the onObjectClicked event. I'll choose the ground object. Next, we'll add an action, using the ground object. We want to set the animation, and we want to set it to dirt. I'll preview the layout. And you can see that when the ground object is clicked, the animation is switched from grass to dirt. But it never regrows. That's where the timer behavior comes in. Let's go ahead and add the timer behavior to the ground object. Select the ground object and click on Behaviors. Select Add New and select Timer under the General category. The timer behavior has no properties. It is only used in the event sheet to trigger an event. To get the timer to trigger an event, we need to do two things. First, we need to start the timer. Then, we need to create an event that specifies what will happen when the timer is triggered. First, let's just get the timer started. We want to start the timer when the player clicks on the ground object, when the animation is switched. So, add an action. Using the ground object, scroll down to the Timer category and select Start Timer. I'll set Duration to 2 so the grass doesn't grow back too fast. Type lets you choose if you want the timer to trigger the event one time and then stop, or to keep triggering repeatedly every 2 seconds or whatever you set the duration to. Leave the tag blank and hit Done. Now, when we click on the ground object, a timer is started, which will trigger an event after the duration of 2 seconds. But nothing will happen because we haven't defined an event for the timer to trigger. So let's add a new event, this time using the ground object, since that is the object with the timer behavior applied to it. Scroll down to the timer category and select On Timer. Here, we can enter the tag for this timer, but remember we left it blank earlier, so we'll leave this one blank as well. Basically, the tag is the name of the timer, but the timer only needs a unique tag if you're using multiple timers on the same object. When the ground timer is triggered, we want to set the ground animation back to grass. So let's add an action to the ground object, choose Set Animation, and set it to the grass animation. Okay, that's it. Let's preview the layout. And when I click on the ground object, it changes to the dirt animation. After 2 seconds, the ground object's timer event is triggered, and the animation is set back to grass. If you click multiple ground objects, it works on each of them as well. The timer's great for triggering events like this, or for causing an event to repeat over a period of time. Just remember to start the timer in an action, and then create an event corresponding to that timer to handle what happens when that event is triggered. For example, a level in a game that lasts 60 seconds. After 60 seconds, the timer event is triggered, and the player and all of the enemies on the screen are frozen. Then you could display your post-level information. There are lots of uses for timers in games, so the timer behavior is a very useful tool to understand.